What's up, guys? It feels so good to be back. I've been out. I was on vacation in Vegas for a week. I don't even know how to do this anymore. I forgot how to do videos. So it'll be like when I did my first video for Predestination 7 years ago, and I was completely stressed out, and I wanted to quit in the middle of the video. I might want to quit in the middle of this video, okay? It's been that long.
Jesus.
But, man, what a way to return with a freaking Hellraiser trailer. You know what? That's a franchise, right? It's a franchise that has a lot of hits and misses and a lot of misses and a whole lot of misses because I'd say the first three movies are good. I'd say the last movie is a nice step back in the right direction. This one has me really interested because we don't have Doug Bradley. Well, we haven't had Doug Bradley back anyway for a while, but this has a female Pinhead, and I'm gonna admit, I'm really interested in this. I've always been interested in the idea of a female Pinhead, and I believe, like, even in the books that I haven't read the books, but I believe that there was like Pinhead's not really given a gender in the books. Am I right on that, guys? If you've read the books, let me know. But and they even teased like a female, like Angelique. I think she was supposed to be more of a Pinhead type figure going forward or something like that. And she was a great character. So I am really, really curious about this movie. It's coming to Hulu. Remember, Prey came to Hulu. Everybody was just like, it looks horrible. Looks like it's going to be woke. But Prey was awesome. Okay. Prey was freaking great. I loved it. I loved it to death. Okay. Also, I have a backup audio going here because it seems like every time I do reactions, my audio gets really messed up because I think what happens is when I lean forward, my mic can get kind of screwy. So I have a backup shotgun mic going right now. So if you hear that pop in and out every now and then, it might be because of that. I don't know. I'm hoping this gives you a nice clear audio stream the whole way through. Okay, we'll see. I spent way too much money in Vegas. If you go to Vegas, you're going to spend, I'm telling you, oh my God. They're going to break your bank, okay? And I will never gamble again. I will never, ever, ever, ever gamble again. You know, famous last words. But, man, I swear, I dropped way too much money in such a short amount of time at the blackjack table. I think it's rigged. I think it's rigged. I think the house has the upper hand, the advantage, right? Okay, so let's do this Hellraiser trailer. Oh, and I get to sport my Tool shirt today. I saw this meme. It said, "Hi, we're Tool. We're better than your favorite band." I like that meme. It's kind of funny. I'll tell more like Vegas little stories after the reaction. Okay, just some little personal things about Vegas. All right, here we go. Anyway, let's do the reaction. Let's do it. Oh, there it is.
Beautiful, isn't it?
It's really nice.
You can hold it.
Oh, that's cool.
What is it?
Box is a little bit different.
And it's almost finished. Keep going.
So if I solve it, do I get a prize?
I do.
Nice, nice.
What's your deal?
It has six sides, six configurations. It opens up and it cuts you. And then they come to collect.
It's time. Greater delights await. We wish to see you proceed. Feed it. Their blood, their pain. All for us.
Oh, yes.
What is it you pray for?
Jesus wept, baby. Holy shit. This might be the best Hellraiser movie since, just by that trailer, since maybe the first. I mean, wow. Like, the second movie, it's ambitious, but it's kind of silly in certain points. But that looks really good. Freaking David Bruckner is directing this, which is always a good thing. That's a great director right there. I mean, the guy did The Ritual and The Night House. Need I say more? When you got a director like David Bruckner that has such a visual stamp on his movies, I don't know, I guess he just has something to say visually, and I love that. Night House, oh my God, that movie is fantastic and dark and hits on some pretty heavy themes. And heavy themes goes hand in hand with Hellraiser. There was one of the Cenobites there that reminded me of the video by Tool for Schism. Have you ever seen that video? There's like a, they're like bending over and their heads are like bobbing. They actually did that when I saw them in concert. They had those creatures like walk out across stage, you know, on all fours, and their heads were like, it was so funny. It'd be funny if that they did that in this this movie. Jamie Clayton as Pinhead, this could work, okay? I think she looks probably the most visually stunning since Doug Bradley. She just has, you know, I guess it all comes down to the face, and her face works very well with the pins, I guess. I love the audio delivery, you know, that they did there.
It's time. Greater delights await.
The voice has a very androgynous approach. You know, it has male and female qualities to it, which is nice. They're not coming right out and saying that, at least in this trailer, that Pinhead is a female. Maybe it's meant to be that way. Maybe it's meant to be androgynous. Story-wise, I think they're keeping it simple, which is what you want to do with a Hellraiser movie. The first movie was pretty damn simple, even though they had a great like lust storyline in the background with Julie and Skinless Frank. And I think most people forget that element of the first movie is part of what's so great, you know? And really, it is the backbone of the movie. It's the core of the movie. Lust leads to opening the gates of hell, you know, opening the box, and here comes Pinhead. I think that's why the first movie is so great. They haven't really captured that ever since. So I'm hoping this movie does have some nice themes in the background, and it's not just a Pinhead and the Cenobites show. And please don't bring in the detective story that they used for like the last 8 Hellraiser movies. It's just basically centered around a detective mystery. You know, that can work, but most of the times it kind of got in the way of the actual story. I mean, hell, sometimes you didn't even see Pinhead for maybe like 1 or 2 scenes. So yeah, I am definitely in for this. Now, I told you I was going to tell you a little bit more about Vegas. I have back problems from time to time. I was in a car accident when I was 17 years old, and it fractured my lower vertebrae in my back. So I constantly have to stretch. I constantly have to take care of my body. And about twice a year, my back will go out on me for nothing. I'll just literally I'll take a step wrong. And next thing you know, I'm walking crooked and bent over. And so my entire week at Vegas just happened to be when my back went out. And it was excruciating. It was not fun at all. Anytime I would be in a sitting position, because we went to the Grand Canyon for one part of it, that was a whole day. And so that was like 4 hours of just sitting. And when I would get up, it's a process just to get up because my back, I would literally be walking like a 90-year-old man. It was kind of embarrassing. Yeah, that's what life is like when you have bad back problems. So that's what I had. And I'm still trying to recover from that trip. You know, anytime I take a trip, it does put a toll on the body, especially on my back. So hopefully I can start coming out of it because usually, you know, most of the time in the year, I'm fine. You know, my back's fine. I run. I'm an avid runner. But when it's like this, it kind of puts everything at a halt. Also, look forward to, I'm going to do a quick review of James Coleman's new short. It's Leatherface, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and it's like 6 minutes long. I haven't watched it yet. I'm going to watch it, but I already know it's going to be great because he did Halloween Inferno. I think there were 3 of those, and they're fantastic. I mean, James Coleman and company, they really hone in on quality fan films. You know, these movies look like they could stand next to, you know, like any current Halloween movie. They're that great. So they use great cameras, great production, great cinematography. You'll see. But anyway, guys, that's my reaction for Hellraiser. Looking forward to this. I'll have to find out when it comes out. I'm definitely going to be getting a review out, maybe a new ranking, even though I would probably have to suffer through watching the rest of the movies because I don't remember them. They all kind of, I guess, bleed into each other. So I would have to rewatch them. They're just, ugh. That's not going to be fun. Also, be sure to come over to Killer Flicks where we talk horror all day and every day on Fridays. We do FIFA Fridays. Follow me at Drum Dumbs on my socials. Support me on Patreon. Buy me a coffee. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a good day. Drum Dumb out.